Hello, and welcome to episode 11, 1-1 of Dream Daddy.
Episode, lucky number 11.
Nice.
Yeah.
11th heaven.
11th heaven,
yeah. We have to add four more children to that family and hit a new TV show.
Jim and Kim's. Oh.
Speaking of the number 11, did you ever, were you ever in school and people asked you if you were 10, 11, or 12? Do you remember that thing?
What?
You were in school and people were like, hey, are you 10, 11, or 12? This was, it's like...
Yeah, vaguely, but I don't actually remember what it's about.
So, if you... So,
is it something to do with being gay?
Yeah.
Okay, go on.
So, like, if you answered 10, they would, like, put up, like, one finger from one of their hands and then make an O with the other hands, like, you're gay, and, put up the finger in the butthole. And then if you said 11, it'd be like, you're gay, like, two dicks. So, if you said 12, they'd be like, oh, all right.
Yeah.
Like, because it's like a two making a V sort of.
Yeah.
For people who can't see my hands, furiously autoerotic. Jabbing
into a very detailed vagina. God, the lips on that vulva, Connor. Maybe it's labia. Who knows? I don't know. I keep watching the game.
I don't think there's a girl I know who calls masturbating tickling her flaps.
Oh, I could have comfortably lived the rest of my life without knowing that, Connor. Oh, I know, I really want to know who it is, but we definitely can't say the name on camera.
It's not like
it's not your girlfriend, is it?
No, thank God. Never said that. Yeah. As far as I know.
Yeah. She said worse things.
Yeah, it's true.
And you know what the best thing is? It doesn't even matter if. Because, you know, no one watches this channel anymore.
Point.
I suppose... because...
Okay. Andrew, please don't have a breakdown in the middle of this episode.
No. That's coming. It's coming. Welcome. Okay. We've gone on... Okay, we're leaving Brian and Matt out. Unless
we could go on a date with Matt.
Matt, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
See what he's about.
So, Matt Sella is an avid music enthusiast.
Matt Sella.
Passionate coffee drinker. You can find me most days selling bean juice over at the coffee spoon or hanging out at the park with my amazing daughter. Nice. Give me a bit about the 80s no-wave music. On a Friday night, I'm most likely to perfect my cold brew setup.
I found a weird like inventor guy who invented a coffee pipe. It's like brew pipe or something where it's like you heat up one shot of coffee and you can drink it through. It's like weird looking.
Okay.
Bripe. It's called the Bripe. Yeah, but he has a video advertising it and it's him just like on like a mountain. Or he's like on a mountain and then like next to like a waterfall and like in his like shorts and he's like, sometimes you just need a hit of coffee. And so that's when your bribe comes in handy.
Oh, Jesus. If I had one thing to take with me onto a desert island, it would be fine tunes to pass the days away.
That's a good point.
My turn-ons are multi-instrumentalism.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to be a barista when I grew up, weirdly enough. And my favorite movie genre is shit with subtitles.
Ooh, nice.
Controversial.
Hentai.
My ID didn't... You just keep saying these things, Connor.
No, it's come over me today.
Yeah, it's... Yeah, Connor is Andrew today.
Yeah.
My ideal date is going to the animal shelter and seriously considering adopting a cat.
What?
Dickhead.
I like to think about getting a cat and then not.
I like to think about getting a cat too, but I live at home with my parents who won't let me get a cat.
Ooh.
Jesus.
You're allergic to cats, Andrew.
I know, yeah. Yeah, well, there's
you're
some
hoping you'll
enough.
Get. Oh, yeah, yeah.
I never leave home without my headphones, both in-ear and over-ear, just in case. This guy's lame. I already regret this.
That's alright.
I spend a lot of time thinking about, where did writing commas into song titles come from? And where did it go? Did we all just agree that it's a bad idea?
Yes.
Anyway.
We did all agree that it was a bad idea.
Yeah. Anyway, what was I saying? I can't remember. I literally had it in my head there 2 seconds ago, and now it's gone.
I went to a gig recently, and all the songs were long titles. It's like, were you there when they crucified the birthday boy?
Did it happen to be Slam Party Deathcore?
Yeah, I wish. Was it? Yeah.
Was it an emo gig?
No, it was
indie jazz rock,
indie rock, country rock, a little bit country vibes. It used to be more like more indie rock.
Oh, okay. What's a Soundgarden?
Ooh. Ooh.
I haven't been to a real concert since Amanda was born.
Hmm. Yeah, that's a thing. Not see a lot of soul patches anymore. Pup are pretty big.
Yeah.
I've listened to a few pop songs.
I have not.
Okay. I've mixed up Pup and I think like Fiddler and some other band in my head. They're all like, yeah, they're all the same.
That's true, they are all the same. Yeah, that's the worst part. What do you do at concerts now? I'll tell you what you do at concerts now. You stand there for an hour.
Drinking a Guinness.
Drinking a Guinness or some shitty beer. With really sore feet. By the minute you step in, your feet are already like, and like, it's just not like, if you're gonna take me to a concert, take me to the Royal Philharmonic or something. At least I get to fucking sit down.
That's
then.
A point. I don't know. I kind of like the like gentle sort of pelvic thrust back and forth that happens at gigs. You know, they're like,
No, you've got a point there. Boom. I mean, I've been to gigs where it's been vicious.
Oh. That's true.
Yeah. Where my entire upper body is moving, while my legs are like pillars on the ground.
Planted for me.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm trying to think of like, what do you do at gigs? Yeah, you just kind of stand there.
Yeah, stand there.
Make a funny comment to your friend every now and again.
Yeah, yeah. Me and Connor like to play spot the industry type when we go to gigs. Yeah. But these days it could literally be anyone. That's the amount of blogs and pop-up sites there are. Not pop-up sites, just sites. They're a punk band. Mm. Yeah, we put up gutter punk, thrash, straight edge.
Sorry, he's talking about pop.
I believe so, yeah.
Well, yeah, they're kind of punky, sort of.
Proto-punk? C-punk? Jeremy punk?
Yeah, Jeremy punk.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh.
Huh? They're not positive hardcore. How dare they?
Canadian.
They are Canadian, that's true. I think they have a bunch of videos with that kid, Stranger Things kid.
Oh, Millie Bobby Brown?
No, the boy.
Oh, Finn.
Finn Wolfhard.
Finn Wolfhard. Yeah. Great name, by the way.
It's a good name.
Great name, yeah.
It's a savage name.
Yeah.
Wish I had that name. Instead, I have the most common name in Ireland.
Yeah. Even my name is like, at least my name comes from the Bible. Yeah. I'm sure he wasn't always St. Andrew, though. Or Andrew the Apostle.
Yeah, he used to be a...
I'm sure he was
used
horribly...
to be Cake Stand Andrew back in his day. Prime. Day,
yeah. Great audio, me cleaning my glasses there. That's where this channel has got. That was it. That was what I was.
I think you know. I think about. we should listen to this because I think they put the song in the. I did actually hear about this, and I think they put the song in the game.
Okay.
And I want to hear which one it is.
Cool. There you go.
When it comes up.
But yeah, I just remembered what I was going to think about, and it's. Mm-hmm. I think it might be gone again from my head. But, what did we literally just mention there?
St. Andrew. My name, Connor, being common.
No, it's gone again.
Andrew,
fuck's sake.
What has happened? It's the years of alcohol.
No, it's the years of alcohol. Yeah, I tell you what. Functional alcoholism is good in many ways. in that I get to forget all my problems in the bottom of a glass, whatever kind of glass it may be. But...
I like to forget my problems in the bottom of a stein.
Yeah, a drinking an ale horn. what was your question, Connor? Oh yeah, functional alcoholism.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah, it's good in many ways, but also it's a crippling addiction. Look like just like my pornography addiction, my weed addiction, and no, I think that's that does it for the main three. Yeah, yeah.
That's fair.
Yeah, Jesse Lacey is my hero. Brand New did nothing wrong. It's technically true, because the band did nothing wrong.
That's a very good point.
Yeah, it's just Jesse, yeah. You shouldn't hate on Brand New just because they wrote the music and enabled this horrible prick to have sex with underage girls.
Yeah. it. Yeah. We finally come to it. We finally come around.
Yeah.
Every like couple episodes, we need to exonerate some sexual abuse.
Yeah. Join us next week for Kevin Spacey.
C-Punk, I'm glad C-Punk is dead.
What is C-Punk?
I mean, it's like Vaporwave, and that was like sort of music, but also like an aesthetic kind of like vibe. Okay. And it was all though. It's all just like dolphins, and like it's
man, that fucking
it's
sucks.
Like purposefully ugly. Like it's all this sea like sort of imagery.
Okay.
You know, like Grimes is almost like C-Punk adjacent, in that I feel like people who like have worked with her are C-Punk, but it's all like they all just look grody and like they've never never showered.
Yeah.
Like that they can't swim either.
Yeah. I was reading an old interview with Grimes there back around the time of her last album 2 years ago, and it was on Pitchfork, and she was like, "Yeah, I just feel like people can't sexualize me." And it's like, "Oh, honey, you've got a storm coming. You have got a storm coming."
That's such a great phrase.
Yeah,
people cannot sexualize.
Yeah, no. No, because her her idea was that her music is so weird, and she's kind of so out there that, you know, it's hard to sexualize something that is so strange. But hey, people draw the yellow pony from My Little Pony with tits just above the unusually detailed vaginas they always give her. So
do you remember the jar, the My Little Pony jar of cum? One of my favorite images. Like the fucking melting.
Oh, I'm gonna get a headache just thinking about it. It's like a needle right through my frontal lobe. Oh.
For anyone who doesn't know, this picture on the internet. Oh. Like My Little Pony doll that look like a shitty like little, like it probably came from McDonald's Happy Meal or something.
Yeah.
But like just
and it's fucking sitting in the cum. Yeah.
Oh. Massive jar. This looks like it's weeks old.
Yeah.
But it's so full. There's so much in it.
It's like twice a day for like 3 weeks.
Longer.
Listen, I come a lot. I know the man. I know what it feels like. But hey, that's a lot of effort just to fill that mason jar. It's not really a mason jar. It's more like a big jam jar. Oh, who's this thing? Sorry,
we can't be insulting C-punkers.
Yeah.
This person kind of looks like they're C-punk. Got the like mermaid hair.
True. Yeah. Or trans. One of the two.
That's it. That's where it came from.
Yeah.
Well. Tally ho, don't say it. Please stop yelling at me.
I just get really excited. That's a lie. No one gets excited about salesmanship.
That is true.
Mm-hmm.
I saw a good tweet that was like, every time I try to hit on a girl, I understand what it's like to be a salesman who doesn't believe in their product.
Yeah, no, he's got a point there. Yeah. Why would I buy something that's already broken? Yeah. Hey. But people bought into Jesse Pablo Lacey here. Pretty much all the time. Money. So.
Ooh, bring it back to Jesse. Mm.
Mm. Yeah. Hey, dude.
I'd like us to hang out with Pablo, just a wizard, and like an agender,
and an agender C-punk,
C-punker. Yeah.
This man looks like he colors with charcoal. His beard looks like you.
That's true.
Yeah. Oh, so something about witch house there.
Witch house.
Do you remember Salem?
That's a good songs. Yeah, Witch House was pretty good when it was around.
Oh. I mean, the problem was that it just didn't translate well live.
Yeah.
Yeah. If you ever look up whatever their really good song is off their first album, I think. I can't remember what it is, but it sounds really good on record. yeah. or digitally or whatever. But it sounds like complete shit.
Yeah.
I assume.
See that. 1, 2, 3, 4 What is this? Yeah, I'm wondering if I should start wearing earplugs to some gigs.
Oh, yeah. Because like... I've been doing, in college, I've been doing audio editing.
And yeah.
The guy who teaches it is really cool.
Yeah.
He was saying that, you know, each time you come out of gig and your ears are ringing,
yeah.
they're irreparably damaged.
Yeah.
So, I think it's a good idea. I mean, I went to see Son O, that mm-hmm. band, with a friend, as a joke, which is something you should never do. because when they say they play loud, man, they play loud.
Mm-hmm.
And my friend Owen, his ears were bleeding by the time we left. We didn't even stay for the full thing. Let's grab another.
That's really what happens at a gig, is you just get binned. Just get locked.
Yeah.
That's the goal, really.
Yeah, that's the goal, really. But it never works out for me, because I never do, mm-hmm. really. We should always buy, because the bar always gets crowded in between intervals.
That's true.
Yeah. You need to arrive.
You need to designate someone mangled. Who doesn't. You need to get someone to go with you who doesn't really like it, and then they can just shepherd beers back and forth.
It was like when we went to American football. That would have been pretty easy to just get binned at.
Yeah.
Just because there wasn't many people there, so it would be pretty easy to go to the bar.
Oh.
Great concert, though.
It was a good concert.
Hey.
Bloody fucking insulting the opening act in front of her friends.
Yeah.
That was my favourite moment, really.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, do you want to tell that story to make up some airspace?
This band, I don't want to say their name, but they were playing and... the singer was putting on like a fake like inner city Dublin accent, and you could tell it was fake as soon as she sang it, but then like she would talk in between, or one of the singers, because I think they were all singing, but like one of the two the lead singers, the shorter middle. You could tell it was fake as soon as she started, but then like she spoke in the middle, I was like, this is not how you speak. But I was saying it to Andrew, and then she just shows up, talk to all her friends that were standing right in front of us.
Avoid these youths.
Oh yeah, this is one of the songs. It's DVR or DLV or something.
Oh, I know.
It's got a cool like music video that's like all we're gonna get pulled for putting this on YouTube because the song is in it.
There's been plenty of doing things that we play.
Yeah.
I don't even know what I'm supposed to do.
Get the hearts and keep going forward.
How big is this?
I hope you're going the right way.
There's no other way to go. What's with the toilet door? What about...
No, it's the evening sex back.
Is it?
Yeah, have you ever gone to a punk gig, Andrew?
No. I didn't think they had bathrooms at punk gigs.
Oh, that's a good point. No, it's a lot of the
Well, if they did, then they were total shit.
A lot of the newer punk bands and like emo bands, a lot of like unisex bathrooms.
Yeah, they got like Modern Baseball, I think.
Yeah, Modern Baseball. I think some of them.
That'd be better.
Yeah, this has a cool like music video. It's all like Super Nintendo and a few like arcade games, but like they put like all the lyrics in it. It's pretty cool.
Nice.
Keep going. Don't die.
I'm trying not to. I don't know what's happening.
I don't even know
what that was. It's really poorly explained.
Okay,
it's alright. It's alright, yeah. Yeah. This area is so cultural.
Is this whole song just gonna play?
Probably, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, well, I think it's opening. Yeah, that's actually the end song. Well, anyways. Alright.
Dude. Hey.
It's all good. Hey. Yo, dude, I got fucking spit on. I got my hands cut up. It was a great gig, though.
Yeah. Hey, man, I got that at work. a year ago when I worked in that discount store. Well, not even a year ago, 2 months ago. Yeah.
And it was great.
And it was...
Hey, yeah.
Can't agree with you there, Connor. Which coincidentally was it. A friend of mine, we were at Kendrick Lamar at Longitude this summer. And the guy I went with ended up starting a fight with a guy with a broken arm.
Nice.
Yeah. Hey. Yeah. So that was fun.
That's... Well, I mean, at least you have an advantage.
unless it turns out to be like The Rock in Fast and Furious 7, and he's
Daddy's gotta go to work.
Flexes, breaks the cast off.
Flexes his muscles into repairing his bones, like shunting them back into place.
Other than Fast and Furious 5, Fast and Furious 6, Fast and Furious 7, Fast and Furious 8, The Rock has not made a good movie.
Nice. That's actually very true.
Yeah.
And he's no.
I mean, I haven't. Don't get me. I haven't.
There's
seen
one
many
that's okay. Movies. That's like the Get Down or something, or the Let Down. No, okay. the Bet Down, the Beat Down. It's something the something down. Yeah. That's okay, and it's like him and I think Sean William Scott. Is that the name of that actor? They're like
wow. That was in American Pie.
Yeah.
Why not?
That's a good point.
Yeah, but other than that, other than those four movies, nothing good. I mean, Jumanji looks shite.
Oh, it looks very bad. Someone in work was telling me that they're like, I am so excited for Jumanji. I am so looking forward to it. Yeah, it looks brilliant.
Yeah.
I'm like, you're crazy. This is the same person who told me that she doesn't watch any movies that are rated 18.
Okay.
She's like, I just figured that they're rated for 18 for a reason, and I don't want that in my life.
You gotta leave that job. There are better jobs out there.
Someone else was talking to me that they like.
Hey.
Someone okay. So one of my managers like is a flat earth theorist.
Continue.
He's just very religious and he doesn't believe in like other planets or anything.
Oh. That's the first time I've heard religion factor into flat earth theory, but go on.
And then there's another guy who doesn't believe the moon landing happened, thinks it's a conspiracy. And I was asking about it, it's like, oh, what do you think happened? And he's like, I just think history. I think you just gotta look at history, man.
Yeah.
It was really shit.
Look at the filmography of Stanley Kubrick.
That's why I was trying to get him on like something like that, but it was just he wouldn't know. Give me no concrete. I was very disappointed. Yeah, well, fuck you as well, Matt.
Yeah, fuck you too, Matt. I knew it was a bad idea.
All right. Well, that's the end of that one.
That's the end of that one. We will see you guys next week. You've got.